Hi students, in this video we are going to see about multi-threading and fine-grained multi-computers concepts in Module 4. Let us go to the topic. So the principles of multi-threading demands that the processor should be designed in a multiple context manner that should handle all the processes in a simultaneous way. So there are two environments should be followed in the multi-threading. What are those means? Architectural environment using multiple context processors and multi-threaded computation model. So these are the two important environmental features that we are going to see it in the multi-threading concepts. So coming to the first one, architecture environment. So in the right side diagram shows the architecture, typical architecture of a one multi-threaded environment. So it contains memory processors, number of processors and also number of memories. And environment, we need to focus on the four important factors here. What are those means? Latency, number of threads, context switching overheads, and interval between the switches. So let us see each definitions one by one. So latency is nothing but there is a one communication latency exists on remote memory access. So in the value of L, that means value of latency, includes the network delays, catch miss penalties, and delays caused because of some contentions, right? So always the latency is nothing but it is a one delay, it's a time taken. So here in the latency includes delays also, some catch miss penalties also, and some of the delays occurred because of contentions also, right? And then second important feature is number of threads, that is defined as capital N, the number of threads that can't be interleaved in each processor. A thread is represented by a context consisting of program counter, register set, and a required context status word. So if you take one multi-threaded environment, one thread is always represented by a context and its program counter and its dedicated register sets and its context status values. Okay, so these four parameters should be associated with each thread in a multi-threaded environment. And context switch overheads. What is meant by context switch overheads? Means it is also a time taken taken to process or taken to switch the threads, switch a thread in a multi-threaded environment. So it refers to the cycles lost in performing the context switching in your processors. And interval between the switches, that is represented by the capital letter R. This refers to the cycles between the threads which are triggered by the remote references, right? So these are all the four important parameters which should be considered in a multi-threaded environment. And move on to the multiple context processes. There is a one formula is derived. It shows the efficiency in case of the context switching technologies. So if the context is busy means, or it is switching, or it is idle, means how we can find out the efficiency. So in that one, one context switching, it can take three states. One is busy states, or it is in switching stage, or it may be in idle stage. So these states represents the amount of time. So how it is measured means it is measured in terms of amount time. Okay, so it is measured in terms of time. So how we can find out with these three values means there is a formula is given, like efficiency is equal to busy divided by busy plus switching plus idle. That means busy divided by number of all three states, right? Like that, the efficiency of your one multiple context processor is calculated. Then move on to your one multi-threaded environment. So this right side diagram shows the multi-threaded environment. So how it is designed means, if you take one thread, it is represented by, I have already told that if you take one thread, it is always associated with or represented with a program counter, register state, and status word, that is defined as PSW, process status word. So these three indices should be there for each thread in a multi-threaded environment. So this is called as multi-threaded environment. Here, number of registers are there. PC is nothing but program counter, and PSW is nothing but process word, status word, and this will be associated with the number of context selects. Here, according to the example, there are n contexts are available, and each having one thread per count. And what are these with context which switching policies are maintained here means, and the first one is switch on catch miss. So when the catch is missed means how we can switch it. So if it corresponds to the case where context is preempted when it causes the catch miss. So wherever the switching is required means, and the first situation is when the catch is missed, and switch on every load. So switching on every load, that is L, independent of whether it will cause a miss or not. So this is not a normal one. So whenever we move on to the switching on to every load, it will cause either a miss or not. And switch on every instruction is also a very important normal thing. It allows switching on every instruction independent of whether it is a load or not. Then fourth policies is switch on block of instruction. That is also a different one. So blocks of instruction from different threads are interleaved. Why it is interleaved means to achieve the ratio of catch hit. So in order to achieve the catch hit, it is interleaved. So those are the four important context switching policies available, and move on to the concept called fine-grained multi-computers. First, we need to understand the meaning of fine-grained parallelism. What is meant by fine-grained? First of all, fine-grained is nothing but one of the programming level to achieve the parallelism. Here, fine-grained is consists of lesser number of instructions. So that's why a program is broken down into a number of large number of small tasks. So if the program is entirely broken into large number of small tasks, means that environment, that technology is called as fine-grained parallelisms. Then communication latency in this multi-grained parallelism, it measures the data or message transfer time on system interconnect. And there are one example is given for the fine-grained multi-computer. Here the design is called as MDP. MDC is one of the example architecture. First diagram shows the MDP printouts. So sorry, pointouts. Here message-driven processor is there. So X, Y, Z are the lines which are connected together as the inputs, and similarly X plus, Y plus, Z plus are the external outputs. Likewise, this diagram shows the chip diagram of MDP design. Here SRAM and SRAM, there are two static RAM assembly is there. Those are called as internal memory, and these are connected with a routers with the help of interfaces connected together. And MDP architecture, this is the MDP architecture, and it has the ALU unit, memory unit, prefetch unit, and network output in and network input unit, and routers unit. And what is speciality here means there are specially designed buses are arranged, or buses are associated with each control units. And move on to the last part. We are going to categorize the characteristics of this fine-grain, medium-grain, and coarse-grain machines with example. Sizes with some of the characteristics. What is the first characteristics means? Communication latency. This communication latency in Cray YMV is about now 40 nanoseconds. Connection MV is about 600 microsecond. Intel IPSC bar I is about 5 milliseconds. MIT J machines is about 2 microseconds. Similarly, synchronization overhead in Cray YMP is about 20 microseconds, 125 nanoseconds, 500 microseconds, and 1 microsecond. Grain size is here 20 size and 200 milliseconds and 500 microseconds. Remark is, this is a Cray YMP is called as a coarse grain, and connection machine SEM2 is called as fine grain, and this medium grain multi-computer as Intel, and MIT J machine is a fine-grained data parallelisms, right? I hope you understand the concept. I'll catch you in the next video about next topic.